Oh, how about it, Stace, again? Today I'm missing one stuffed rabbit. I haven't been over seeing recording it, so I can. So after this video, I can listen to it. And it was Friday afternoon, and everyone in the second grade was excited. Poco, the class pet, we spent the whole weekend with one of them. The classroom grew quiet as Mrs. Robin picked a name. Coco will be going home with Denise, he called. Everybody, before I told the paints, comment who do you think Denise is. It gives you a couple seconds. Okay. She almost fell because I think the bag is big one. The answer was Jean went up and down with Coco in his diary in her arms. Coco was not a blue rabbit. He was a brown stuffed rabbit. He was an important part of Mrs. Robin's second grade class. You'd say someone's name was picked from a big bone, and that sound got to take Coco home overnight. Coco traveled everywhere with his diary. Each student helped him write his thoughts and smiles. This is Coco's diary. Monday, I went home with Addie. I met her bunny Snowball. He did not look like me. Oh wait, I forgot to show you guys pictures. Oh, let me see if you guys saw. Monday, I went home with Addie. I met her bunny Snowball. He did not look like me. Addie read cross out me, but I said me because that's the word me, but they spelled the wrong. The wrong way. Me, Peter Rabbit. It was a great storm. Tuesday. I went to the playground with Danny after school. We played on the monkey bars. I fell and broke my leg. Danny fixed it. Wednesday, Matthew put me in his backpack. We went to soccer practice. Matthew let me wear his favorite hat. I cheered when I got a goal. Thursday, after school, I went to the roller skating green cross out rink with Christina. My leg is broken, so I just watched. Christina's sister fed me a jelly sandwich. My bowl is sticky. Blue was beaming when her mom picked her up. Guess what? I can keep Coco for the whole weekend. She slid into the car. Her baby sister, Kristen, tried to grab Coco. Mine, she said. Can you put the That afternoon, Janine took Coco and then told Nana. Nana cut some carrots for her that night. At home, Janine read Coco a story and tucked him in bed. On Saturday, Janine and Coco did everything together. On Sunday, the family went to the mall Coco came to. They went from store to store searching for just the white shoes. Finally, they each found the perfect pail along with lots of other things. "I'm starving," said Mom. "Let's go for lunch." Everybody, see if you can find any bad things. I'll give you a couple seconds and then I'll point it out. Okay, it's right there. Coco got lost in the Swiddles that are for sale, because sale Swiddles. They piled their bags into the booth. "Let's get a high chair for Coco," said Jenny. "Coco? It's Coco!" Coco. They looked in all the bags. "No, Coco! Dad, look under the table." "No, Coco. Oh, no!" Jenny cried. "I lost Coco. I've been calling Coco Coco." "Calm down," said Dad. "We'll just retrace our steps." "Dad, we avoid every store in this mall. We'll never find him." The family spent the rest of the afternoon looking the mall for Coco. They even checked the lost and found apartment 3 times. On Monday morning, Janine had to go to school. Without Coco, she stood in front of the class and read from his diary. "Weekend. I went home with Janine on Friday. On Saturday, we rode her bike. On Sunday, I got lost in the mall. Please help Janine find me." And then, as you can see there, to sit down for you guys, sorry I told it. Down Janine's cheek. I just thought I would read that. Well, the book was upside down. "Don't worry, Janine. You are our hope," said Mrs. Robin. "How about if we make posters?" suggested Addie. "Great idea," Mrs. Robin handed out papers. "This is the pictures and what it says. I'll give you guys a couple seconds if you want to read it, and then I'll read it. Missing. 1 stuffed rabbit. Name, Coco. Description, brown fur, broken left leg. Lost at the North Shore Mall. Call Oaklandville School 555-1234. Tuesday after school, Mrs. Robin, Janine, and 3 classmates went to the mall. They hung up all the posters and checked the lost and found department again. No, Coco! As they were leaving, Addie noticed the display. The sign read toy drive. Toys wanted. Addie and Janine ran to the counter. "Here's where all these toys go," asked Janine. "We bring them to the children's hospital," said the woman. Mrs. Robin said, "I'm called Janine. I'll bet Coco is at the hospital." "Let's go," shouted the children. All went to the hospital. As they went inside, they saw something amazing. A big green frog was handing out toys and poking out of the top of his basket was 1 stuffed rabbit, Coco! Just then, the frog gave Coco a little girl. "Thank you," said the little girl. "Look, he has a broken leg, just like me." "Oh no," whispered Janine. "Isn't he cute?" The little girl held up Coco. "I'm going to name him Cinnamon. I'm going to take care of him. He gave Coco a big hug to me, looked at her friend, then at her teacher. She cleared her throat. I think Cinnamon, was lucky to find you. Cinnamon moves closer to the little girl. My name is Janine. I'm Teresa. At that moment, the frog gathered everyone together for some photos. Snap, snap. He gave pictures to Janine and Teresa. The next morning, Janine stood in front of the class and held up pictures she read from Coco's diary. Tuesday, Janine and the others found me. I am now with someone who really needs me. My name is Teresa. She loves me and will take good care of me. I had a lot of fun in the class, but I won't be coming back. Love, Coco. P.S. My new name is Cinnamon. P.P.S. Please write to me and Teresa. And that's just what they do. Bye, everybody.